Welcome back to Open Line. We have with us two members of Community Oversight Now, Theda Murphy, Arnold Hayes, and we have several calls. We have a lot of calls based on the first part of the show and our conversation there. What is needed in Metro's next police chief? That is a conversation that is being had all across Davidson County, and it's one we're having here tonight. So let's go to the phones. Let's go to Kenny, who is on the line here. Hello, Kenny.
Yes.
Go right ahead. What is on your mind?
All right, I'm Kenny Hardy. I'm a two-time candidate for Davidson County Sheriff. And I'm a retired police officer with over 22 years of service, and I have degrees in criminal justice, sociology, blah, blah, blah. What Nashville needs in the police department, I agree with the Community Oversight Board that it was funded and it should be supported by the people because they voted on it. It was put on the ballot. The reason they're having such issues with it is because they're outsiders to the police and law enforcement community. You have to be able to establish that rapport and that relationship with the police department before they will even work with you. Now, they shouldn't have the problems they're having. You also have to work with the people that you hire that should know the police culture. The sheriff, the police department, they all have to work together. They should give back some of that authority back to the sheriff department so they can get out there and patrol. We've got a shortage of police officers still, but we still have a police department that's not being effective. So it starts at the head with the chief. If the chief is not going to support, the rest are going to follow. So here's what I suggest. When you're looking for a new police chief, yes, somebody from outside would be very important. But every time Nashville goes outside to bring somebody inside, we have the same problem. The chief works at the pleasure of the sheriff, of the mayor. And the mayor can fire the chief. However, there are some other things they have to do. So if you're going to pick a chief, the community should have a sit-down talk, just like we did for mayor and for any other elected official. Even I had to sit down in the community and explain my thoughts on why I would make a great sheriff. We should have the same thing with our tax dollars being spent to select next chief. We're spending money on a system to go find a new police chief, and we don't have money for programs for kids who don't have internet service. But we got money to go find a new chief to spend to find a new chief, and that's not right. You have plenty qualified people who have no ties to the police department here, which I am one of them, and you will never, ever hear a word from people like me because it's about money. It's about people who already have paid that way. You need people who are not tied to that police department to start making some more decisions.
All right, so people not tied to the police department, that seems to mirror what you all are saying in some way. You want an outsider. I think that's part of what Kenny's saying there. We have so many calls. I'm just going to keep moving on, and then I'll let you all comment. Is that okay? Let's just go to Ann here. Hello, Ann. Go right ahead.
Good evening. The first thing a new police chief needs to do is attend a community oversight board meeting, which is something Chief Anderson refused to do. That in itself shows support to the Community Oversight Board. My question for both of y'all tonight is, for some time now, the board has tried to get the use of force report and has met with quite a bit of resistance. And now we've heard, or maybe I'm heard wrong, the mayor was going to step in and assist in that, and I'm still hearing that those reports are not coming. Yesterday, our new police chief was asked about the sexual harassment allegations, and his response was he did not know if this was one or more people involved, and I happen to know this was a lengthy submission of papers that was a report turned over. And if Officer Drake does not know that these reports are against more than one officer, he does not qualified to be submitting his name for our next police chief.
Okay, all right, let's talk about both those things.
Yes.
Okay, use of force. The use of force report and the sexual harassment, either one of you can take that. Who wants to take it?
Well, we have been asking for those use of force reports to be made public for a while now. And they guard them like they're, you know, like they're hiding something. And, you know, they need to be made public so that people can see how they are adjudicating or determining what is a proper use of force. We need to know that. That's something that the public should know.
Okay. And then she was talking about sexual harassment. Did you want to add? Do you want to add anything about that, Arnold Hayes?
Well, I do understand there was numerous complaints, you know, concerning assault and sexual harassment within the department. And I know there was a report in the Tennessean where it was a comment from the mayor, but, you know, but if leadership is not understanding or not getting that information, that says something's wrong with the system. I mean, if the mayor and the police chief cannot get information readily, but what do you think gonna happen with the regular citizen trying to get information? Yes.
Let's go to—
That's why we're asking for an independent investigation.
Right, on the sexual harassment. Let's go to James. Hello, James.
Yes, sir.
Go right ahead.
Thank you for taking my call. I'm just a layman, I'm retired, and I don't know much about politics, but I don't think that the police department should be defunded. I believe that leads to anarchy. Also, I believe that as a layman, I don't understand a lot of politics, but I believe that from the last three mayors, between the last three mayors and the council, city council, we've been lied to, because now, you know, the mayor is asking for like a 32% property tax. So where's all the money at, you know? And I don't think that we should go outside of our community to look for a police police chief. And also that we shouldn't be giving big companies 20 and 30 year tax break. Also,
okay, well, you're hitting all kinds of things. You got the property tax increase and tax incentives. All right, what he said first was he doesn't believe the police department should be defunded. And Theda Murphy, you indicated perhaps it should be, and took the definition of that to mean not just reallocating money, but essentially abolishing, as I understood it. That would seem to be contrary to what a lot of public opinion polls would support. And certainly it would be hard to get a new police chief to come in if the department were abolished. But here's a caller who's saying he doesn't support that. What do you say?
Well, I say that even within Community Oversight Now, there's a diversity of opinion about that. And I happen to be on the abolish end. But I believe we all agree that the police department does need to be reformed. And we also agree, because we live in Nashville, that we have a budget crisis. And our schools need money. Our health institutions need money. And the police department is taking up a lot of those funds. So the question would be, why aren't they being scrutinized as to how they're using those funds, so that we can see whether we can reallocate those funds to some other areas where they're lacking?
Arnold Hayes, do you want to add something to that?
Again, smarter, not harder. I'm sure within any organization there are things that people can do more efficiently. And when it comes to things like the budget and everything, I do believe the police department usually gets their fair share of the budget. Now, yes, there may not be an adequate budget where the schools suffer and a lot of the other departments suffer, but usually the police department is usually gonna get theirs. they usually going to get a pretty decent share of things. It may not be exactly what they feel that it's needed, but usually they're going to get their fair share.
Okay, we have to take a break. If you're online, hold on. We have several calls, so hold on, and we will get to your call. Take a break. We'll be back right after this.